Divin avertissement concernant un des lieux les plus diaboliques au monde. 27 janvier 2015. Message de Yahushua à sa messagère Gwendolyn Rix, traduit et lu par Justine.
What are you going to talk about?
Yeah.
A fraud? No, it wasn't a fraud, but I'll be glad to talk to you if you'll shut up and let me talk now. And a fraud? Let me tell you something. I'll tell you a couple of stories about fraud. The Bohemian Club. Did you say the Bohemian Club? That's where all those rich Republicans go up and stand naked against redwood trees, right? I've never been to the Bohemian Club, but you ought to go. It'd be good for you. Get some fresh air.
Yes, sir. First question?
Yeah.
I'm sorry. You gave a keynote speech at the Bohemian Grove Club, sir, a club which openly has mock child sacrifices and satanic worship, sir. Can you answer my question, sir, please?
I was very pleased. I was very pleased with my performance in the debate. It was a good debate.
What about the Bohemian Grove Club, though, sir? That's very important. They do mock human sacrifices there, sir, and you reported being there.
I was very pleased with my performance in the debate.
Sir, why did you ignore my question, sir? Can we have...
He's running up a storm about that Bohemian Grove over there. Human sacrifices, a male prostitute shipped in there yearly. That Bohemian Grove over there. Human sacrifices, a male prostitute shipped in there yearly.
Governor, Bohemian Grove, actually. You said before that did you or did you not attend Bohemian Grove in San Francisco?
The gathering is packed with oil tycoons, politicians, business leaders, and foreign diplomats who all make the pilgrimage to this yearly Redwood campout. Presidents Nixon, Reagan, and George W. Bush all attended the Grove before they graced the Oval Office.
So Abby mentioned a few people in attendance at Bohemian Grove. Here's actually a direct quote from former President Richard Nixon. He said in his memoirs, "If I were to choose the speech that gave me the most pleasure and satisfaction in my political career, it would have been my Lakeside speech at the Bohemian Grove in July 1967. Because this speech traditionally was off the record, it received no publicity at the time. But in many ways, important ways, it marked the first milestone on my presidency."
Let us look at Northern California. You understand?
Yeah.
You know what's happening in
San Francisco. Just gone.
It's clear over. I understand. But it isn't just not in the ratty part of town. Now, but the upper class in San Francisco is that way. The Bohemian Grove that I attend one time at a time. The Easterners and the others have come there. But it is the most that you will ever imagine in San Francisco crowd because it's just terrible.
Free owl of Bohemia, we thank thee for thy adjury.
Have you been there for the ceremony with the cremation of care?
Frankly, I don't think that's something I need to talk to you about. And I'm sorry you violated the understandings. That was not a gentlemanly thing to do.
But what about the ritual? Is the ritual gentlemanly?
Think about
it. The ritual?
That's none of your damn business.
Oh!
And what you're looking at here, staggeringly, is a group of people, some of the most famous people in America, in long gowns. Behind them there, you see a 40-foot stone owl. And there's the fire between them, next to the lake at Bohemian Grove. Now, one might wonder, understandably, why the people that run the banking, political, economic system and the media in America should be dressed in long robes doing a ceremony to a 40-foot stone owl. I think we should be told.
And no doubt you'll be hearing about all the differences between John Kerry and George W. Bush. But we've discovered they do have something in common. During their respective college days at Yale, they both belonged to a group called Skull and Bones.
You were both in Skull and Bones, the secret society.
It's so secret we can't talk about it. It's so secret we can't talk about it.
What does that mean for America?
You both were members of Skull and Bones, a secret society at Yale. What does that tell us?
Not much, because it's a secret.
Le Seigneur Yahushua a commencé. Mes très chers enfants, Aujourd'hui, je délivre un message très important aux enfants de Dieu concernant l'un des endroits les plus sataniques sur cette terre. Je veux pointer du doigt cet endroit afin que les enfants de Dieu commencent à prier pour ceux qui habitent près de ce site qui rend hommage à Satan chaque jour. Je permets à mes enfants d'entrer dans le cœur de leur Créateur, tandis que je délivre ce message au travers de ma messagère des temps de la fin, Gwendolyn Ricks. Je viens aussi pour rétablir les faits une fois de plus, de sorte qu'à la fin de l'ère de l'Église, il n'y ait plus rien qui soit fait en cachette contre les enfants de Dieu qui n'aient été exposés à la lumière. Je suis aussi la lumière, mes enfants, et je montre la voie pour que tous mes enfants se repentent et qu'ils reviennent à moi en cette heure très tardive. Le Bohemian Grove est vraiment l'épicentre du culte satanique aux États-Unis. Le Bohemian Grove est aussi l'endroit où les enfants de Lucifer versent le sang de mes autres enfants innocents, tandis qu'ils exhibent de manière grotesque leur amour pour le roi de l'enfer. Je veux que tous mes enfants soient tout à fait conscients des activités qui ont lieu sur ce lopin de terre satanique. S'il vous plaît, distribuez la vidéo de mon fils Céo aussi loin et aussi largement que vous le pouvez. Dans les jours futurs, je susciterai un grondement sous le sol de cette propriété qui arrachera les plumes du légendaire hibou qu'il vénère. Je ferai s'effondrer toute structure et les consumerai par le feu dévorant de mon père. Entendez-moi en ce jour, ô enfant du Dieu très haut. Je ne supporterai pas davantage ce blasphème. Je suis un Dieu patient, mais je suis aussi un Dieu de vengeance, et en cette heure tardive, la vengeance est mienne, dit le Seigneur des armées. Priez constamment, mes enfants, car je viens remettre les choses en ordre. Seigneur Yehoshua.